So SvelteKit 1.0 is finally released, and now it's time to get it into production. One thing I have on my site is allowing the users to change languages and filter the content based on that language. How can you do that with SvelteKit? Let's create a project here in Statblix. Let's choose full stack and SvelteKit. SvelteKit allows you to use simple forms to perform mutation operations. Delete some of these things that you'll not use, and let's create a form. The form will hold a select element to allow the users to choose one or two options, English and Spanish. Let's name the select input here as lang and pass the correct values to each of the options. There you go, a simple select element inside a form inside the page. Now the form needs to send the data to the backend of your application, and that is done by simply using the post method and passing the action that you want. But SvelteKit allows you to use progressive enhancement into the forms, and to do that, pass the use enhance action to the form. Now you need to allow the user to submit the selected value. To do that, let's listen for the unchanged event on the select box and just automatically submit the value by running this function. Now the select is automatically submitted the form to this action, but let's name this action to know exactly what it does. Now it's time to create a server-side file to create the actions. SvelteKit allows you to write actions to listen for the form events. Let's create this async function that first will read the form data, and now using that lang value, we'll set a cookie named lang, and we'll return success as true. Now you need to read the cookie to pass that value into the page, and that is done by using the load function. So let's create this simple function. The first thing you do is read the user agent's selected language and then create a default lang. The default lang will be the one that is accepted by the browser or English otherwise. After that, let's read the current cookie value. If the current cookie doesn't exist yet, let's set that using the default lang value. And finally, from this load function, return the lang variable as the current cookie value. Let's add this request argument here that was missed. And now from the page, it's time to read the data that has been passed from the server side. That is, let the user know what language has been selected. To do that, let's export the data variable here that will hold the values passed from the server side. Now you can see that the UI showed that the current language is English because that is the default. And if I change the select box, it's now shown as Spanish. And if I reload, it's still Spanish because as you can see here in the DevTools, the current cookie value is Spanish, but you cannot change to English. That is because the select box has to be bound to the current language value. Now, the select box and the value displayed in this line show the correct selected language, same as the cookie. So there you go. To allow the user to update the selected language for the page, you created a form that communicates to the backend using an action. The backend file reads the action and set the cookie based on the data selected by the user. And also it loads that data from the cookie to pass it into the page to be able to use it or display it.